Welcome to episode 139 of diecast TV channel. In this episode, Falcon has an update on the saga of empty Hot Wheels pegs at Kmart, Eagle hunts through some 2014 FK short cards at a countdown supermarket, and lastly, I wrap up with a Tonka diecast truck review. If I can find where I left it.
What's he lost now, boys?
When we last reported on Hot Wheels at Kmart, they were running on empty, with remnants of B cases they received back in late October 2013. Over 5 months ago. So this week we were pleased to find that one branch of Kmart, and I mean just one branch of Kmart, had filled up their Hot Wheels pegs. It looked like 5 2014 G cases, as we found 5 rescue duty regular hunts hidden among the main lines. Sadly, with the G cases already available in other stores for several weeks, Kmart didn't offer any cars we needed, including the hunts, which he left behind for other collectors. Unfortunately, the majority of these G-case cars will now end up as peg warmers, delaying the next batch of fresh cases.
A bit like Kmart, the local supermarkets have really slowed down their Hot Wheels restocks in the past 6 months. We used to go into our local countdown supermarket and find fresh stock out almost every fortnight, but now it's more like every couple of months. Luckily for us, a weekly grocery shopping visit to the supermarket coincided with a 2014 F-case restock. On the blue hanger there were 4 sweet castings that we instantly scooped up, 3 very desirable homers, and a loop coupe regular hunt. The first short card hunt we've scored in ages. And while looking through some more Hot Wheels sitting in overstock above the toy aisle, we came across this unusual short card error. It's a horse play with part of the body missing on the rear right corner. You sometimes see metal bodied cars with a void in the casting, but this is the first plastic bodied one we've seen like this. Over now to Cobra, who I hope has tracked down that Tonka truck.
All under control, Eagle. At most stores here, the toy aisles are divided up into dedicated areas based on brand. You've got Hot Wheels, Matchbox, Disney Cars, Maisto, and Tonka. Hey, Tonka, we haven't reviewed one of those for a while. Which one do we choose?
The team of three mostly collect Hot Wheels and Matchbox brands in our collection. The reason for that is that the quality, the price, the variety of makes and models you can get, the availability of the cars here, and also the realism of the models is, in our opinion, superior to the other brands that we can get. So take a look at this Nissan Skyline GTR R34. This is a typical example of the sort of car that we collect, Japanese performance sports cars. This has an absolutely gorgeous blue paint job on it. Nice decals on the side. You've got rear tempo treatment. And it's also got a very detailed interior. So this casting really highlights why we like Hot Wheels and Matchbox. Compare it to the Maisto equivalent, which we took a look at last episode. Falcon and I bought a couple of these loose cars and a tanker truck. So you can see that this has a solid window, so no interior decals. We've got wheels here that are pretty cheap. And if I roll it, you hear how noisy that is compared to the Hot Wheels car. Now another brand that's quite nostalgic is Tonka. So Tonka have been around for a while, and looking on the back of this packet here, I can see that there's a Hasbro logo. So Hasbro, of course, are in competition with Mattel, who make Hot Wheels and Matchbox. So we actually have the competitor's product in front of us here. Now, we might as well start at the back here. We've got 5 different trucks in this Big Rig series. There's a flatbed logger, there's a tanker, a flatbed pipe, a cargo, and a flatbed crate. So I've got this one here, the cargo Big Rig. And as you can see from the casting itself, it's quite a large size. It looks like it would be good for kids. And I think that's really the market that this particular product's aimed at. A kid could easily hold the cab and the trailer there. They're not going to get hurt by any loose parts. And it looks quite rugged and durable. So I really like the graphics on this. Now, I've had my eye on this particular truck for probably about 9 months. I don't know if you can see it in the camera, but there's actually quite a bit of dust along the top there because it's just been sitting on the pegs for so long. Really, the warehouse overpriced them. They're priced there at $14.99. So I've been waiting for as I say, quite a few months now to for them to come down on clearance. And that happened today. Today they came off at 25% discount. So I managed to save a few dollars on this, and I thought it was worth picking up. So I'm going to crack it open now, and then we can have a quick look at it. Right, so I've cracked it open. Looks pretty impressive. You can see the trailer graphics here, where it says Tonka. I actually found about 5 of these models on the pegs, and I looked at each one carefully, and I chose the one that had the best graphics on it. Some of them had smudges and marks and all sorts of things on the trailer there, so I tried to pick the best one I could find. It's got some painted rear lights there, painted tail lights, which is a nice feature. Door doesn't open or anything, this is a sealed trailer. So if we detach the cab, it's a simple sort of lift it up and drop it in. There's no sort of hook, nothing to sort of push forward and back to lock it in place. I guess that's so that children can easily take it apart. And there's a little stand here so that the trailer can be parked by itself. Looks like maybe a refrigerated unit. Seems like it may have an air conditioner or something like that on the front. And the tractor unit here, I'm not sure what model truck this is representing, whether it's a Kenworth or a Ford or a Peterbilt or Mack or something like that. But it has a lot of details. You can see it's got a fuel tanks on each side. It's got the smokestacks. Got a beautiful grill with a Tonka logo in the center. It's missing headlights, which would be nice. Has rear tail lights, and there's that circular hole where the trailer plugs into. So that's the fifth wheel, is what they call it, but you can see it's no locking mechanism there. So pretty impressive details. There's just a solid window there. There's no interior on this, but for a child's model, I guess, you know, what do you expect? It's perfectly acceptable. So it rolls pretty smoothly. I can see there's a little bit of wobble in some of the wheels. And if you hear a squeak, I notice that Matchbox trucks also, the Matchbox big rigs, also make a squeaking noise. And I think it's just the way that the metal axles are rubbing against the plastic base. So I'm really happy with this purchase. This is an excellent addition to my collection. I hope you've enjoyed watching this, and maybe if you guys have Tonka in your area, you might want to invest in one of these as well. Thanks for watching.
That's it for episode 139 of DCTV Channel. Thank you to all of our channel viewers and subscribers for watching. All the best from the team of three at DCTV.